Guys, welcome to today's class. In this class, we discuss few more problems based on how to solve a maxima minima for function of more than one variables along with constraint or condition using Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Find the one of the problem is already written on the board. Find the dimension of the rectangular box open at the top. Rectangle box is open at the top. And then I have to find out the maximum capacity whose surface is 432 square centimeter. Find the dimensions of the rectangular box. That box is open at the top. Then I have to find out what type of that. I have to find out that dimensions of this box of maximum capacity whose surface area what they are given 432 square centimeter. This is a condition they given. Based on this condition, I have to find out the maximum capacities must be taken. For what dimension is have taking maximum capacity for the rectangular box is open at the top. Okay. Now here I am going to take let x, comma y and z with the dimensions. You know it's a three dimension, no? With the three dimensions of the box. Okay. Then from that, what's the volume of this box? Volume is a function of what actually x, y, z. What's the volume of this box is nothing but x into y into z. Okay. Now, I'm going to take what is my surface formula for the surface area. The surface area is denotes x. Again, surface area is depends upon what are the variables x, y, z. X, y, z is nothing but because observe this rectangular box is open at the top. Therefore, what's the surface area formula here? X, y plus 2 into y, z plus 2 into z, x. Because it's open at the top, therefore, here you can't take twice. Okay, square that is already given. What's the surface area they given? 432 square centimeter. This is a condition. Means it is enough to find out maximize V of x comma y comma z is nothing but x y z subject to what's the condition? XY plus 2YZ plus 2ZX must be equal to 432 square centimeter. Yeah, this is a question they given in the theoretical form. You can't expecting always they given a function. Suppose they provide a theoretical. From the theoretical, carefully I have to write what's a maximum maximize and minimize function subject to what's a condition. This is they asking in the problem. Okay. Now I'm writing the theoretical problem in terms of mathematical expression. Then next, if you want to apply the Lagrange's method, first you have to write the auxiliary equation. What's my auxiliary equation? Auxiliary equations are nothing but, is capital F of other than small v and what about phi, you have to take capital F of x by z must be equal to V of x, y, z plus lambda into phi of x, y, z. Okay. It is already explained how to take the value of phi of x, y, z. Before I'm going to take phi of x, y, z, based on the condition, we are going to take phi of x, y, z. How to take phi of x, y, z? First, you convert the right hand side must be 0. After that, what are the terms you have in the left hand side is nothing but our phi of x by z. We already discussed in the previous class. Okay, fine. In the next step, now I have to substitute what is my v of x by z is x into y into z plus lambda into what is this actually xy plus 2yz plus 2zx minus 432. Okay. This is my capital F of x, y, z. Fine. Now I have to find out first order partial derivative of f with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. With respect to x, y and z are constant, y z into 1 plus lambda into partial derivative of this with respect to x is y into 1. Y z is constant, what is derivative of constant is 0. Well, come to this term, 2 into what is 2z into what is derivative of x with respect to x1 and constant is 0. This is nothing but my fx. Next, try to find out fy. Finding with respect to y, treated the remaining variables are constants. What are the remaining variables? X and z. Now, from the first term, x and z are constant into partial derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Therefore, with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z, this term is not equal to 0 plus lambda into x into what is derivative of y with respect to y is 1, 2z into what is derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Okay. Similarly, I have to find out fz. While finding fz, x and y are constant into partial derivative of z with respect to z is 1 plus lambda into first term is 0 because it's free from z, is a constant. While come to the second term, 2 into y into what is derivative of z with respect to z is 1 plus 2x into what is derivative of z with respect to z is 1. This is constant, this is 0. Okay, fine. Now, these are the thing we get. From this, what we are going to do? I write fx is equal to 0, fy is equal to 0, and also fz is equal to 0. Okay, fine. While equating fx and fy, fz is equal to 0, what we get actually? That implies yz plus lambda into y plus 2z equal to 0. Okay, fine. The next is what actually? Xz plus lambda into x plus 2z is equal to 0. Okay. And next, xy plus lambda into 2y plus 2z, 2x, sorry, 2x is equal to 0. I told number of times after equating fx, fy, fz equal to 0, find out from each of the term what is my lambda. What is my lambda? Lambda is a commonly involving all three equations. Better to find out the value of lambda. What is my lambda value from the first equation? Minus yz divided by y plus 2z. Okay. From the second equation, what is my lambda? Lambda is nothing but minus xz divided by x plus 2z. Okay. Third equation implies what is my lambda? Minus xy divided by 2y plus 2x or 2x plus 2y. Choice of you. Now here observe carefully, all are we have get a different values of lambda. Therefore, what I'm going to do here, minus yz divided by y plus 2z. Just like don't confuse here, you already know that basic thing. X is equal to a, x is equal to b, x is equal to c. A is equal to x also equal to b, x also equal to c. Therefore, we get a is equal to b is equal to c. Like that here. Now, minus yz plus divided by y plus 2z equal to lambda. Lambda also equal to minus xz divided by x plus 2z is also equal to lambda is minus xy divided by 2y plus 2x. You know that a is equal to b is equal to c means a is equal to b, or you have to take b is equal to c, or to take c is equal to a. Choice of you. Like that. Now, I am equating first two. That implies, is it clear? I think it's clear everyone for this part. Okay. Yeah. This implies I am going to take minus yz divided by y plus 2z equal to minus xz divided by x plus 2z. I think it's clear now. Now, see, observe carefully here. Minus zz cancel, minus n also cancel. You take a cross multiplication. From the cross multiplication, what we get? Y into x plus 2z, okay, minus x into, okay, y plus 2z, okay, not minus, minus sign is cancelled, okay, fine. Here minus n is removing that. You take this as cross. take it like that, okay, cross multiplication. Now this is what actually xy plus 2zy equal to xy plus 2xz, okay, fine. Now in the next step, xy is cancelled, 2 is cancelled, and this is 2 actually, 2 is cancelled and also z is cancelled. That implies x is equal to y. We get a relation for x is equal to y. Similarly, I equate to last 2. From the last 2, therefore minus xz divided by x plus 2z. See, I told number of times, first you equate fx, fy, fz equal to 0. From that you find out lambda. Once you find out the lambda, we get is in the form of a is equal to b is equal to c. Take a is equal to b, take b is equal to c. Try to find out each and every variable in terms of single variable. Then easy to find out the critical value or critical point. Minus what actually xy divided by 2y plus 2x. Now observe carefully here, minus sign have a common, okay, fine. Xx cancel it, and then I take a cross multiplication like that. What we get, z into 2y plus 2x equals y into x plus 2z. That implies 2zy, okay, 2zx, yes, yx plus 2zy. Observe carefully, 2zy, 2zy is cancelled, x is cancelled, okay. Now we get z in terms of y, okay. That implies 2z equal to y, that implies what is my z, y by 2. Now here we get x is y and also z is y by 2. Take the constraint equation. What's a condition? The given condition is nothing but our constraint. Surface area is equal to 432 square centimeter. Given, okay, fine, xy plus 2yz plus 2zx must be equal to 432. Yeah, what is my x? Y square. What is my z? Y by 2, okay. What is my z? Y by 2. What is my x? Is y. 432. That implies y square. 2 cancel. Y square plus y square is equal to 432. That implies what is my y? Observe carefully. 3y square equals 432. That implies what is y square? 432 divided by 3 is nothing but 144. 4 1 3 1 3 4 4. Y square is equal to 144. What is y? Y is equal to plus or minus 12. But I want to find out maximum. Capacity containing where in the rectangular box is open at the top. I want to find out maximum. Therefore, what's a critical point I'm going to take? Only y is equal to 12. Don't take minus 2. Actually, we get two values. Actually, y is equal to 12 and y is equal to minus 12. Okay, fine. From these points, if y is equal to 12, what is my x value? It's also 12. And also z value is what actually 12 by 6. What is 12 by 2? What is 12 by 2 is 6. If y is equal to minus 12, what is my x? X also minus 12. What is my z? Minus 12 by 2 is minus 6. This implies what are the critical points? 12, 6 and minus 12, minus 12. Minus 6 are the critical points. But here I want to find out maximum capacity. Therefore, which what about which critical point you raise maximum compared to these two? 12, 12, 6. Therefore, I'm going to find out the maximum value at this point. Okay. And we are going to neglect for this because they are asking the maximum. Therefore, this give rise maximum, this give rise minimum. They are not asking both. Suppose they are going to ask both, then you have to find out maximum value for what actually V of x, y, z is nothing but at which point? 12, 12, 6. You calculate, it's nothing but 12 into 12 into 6, 144 into 6, 864. Okay. Centimeter. Minimum value is nothing but V of x, y, z at minus 12, yeah, minus 12, minus 6 is nothing but minus 864. Okay. But they are asking the dimensions. Dimension means x, y, z. For what dimension we get the rectangular box having a maximum capacity? For what's a conclusion I'm going to write? Hence, x is equal to 12 centimeter, y is equal to 12 centimeter, and x is equal to z is equal to what actually 6 centimeter. Gives the maximum volume. Okay, fine. Gives maximum volume. This is a way I to find out the maximum volume. I want to find out means what are the dimensions they expecting. X is equal to 12 centimeter, y is equal to 12 centimeter, and z is equal to 6 centimeter. This way I to find out the maximum or minimum value, or they asking the dimensions. Therefore, this way I to find out. Say what's a minimum dimension means here minus 12 and 6 centimeter. Yeah. If you want, I'm showing entire problem in two screenshot, because then easy to understand this. Is it okay or not? Is it clear? Now, once you clear, anybody want the entire problem? It's not possible to show it in one screenshot because it's a very, I'm written each and every step on the board. Therefore, very lengthy. Therefore, if you want to cut down simple steps, okay? Now, before move to the next step, I'm going to explain. First, you frame a auxiliary equation based on the given function and based on the constraint. After that, you find out the first order derivative equal to 0. From that equations, try to find out lambda. Using the values of lambda, try to find out a is equal to b is equal to c. From that, you take a is equal to b or b is equal to c or c is equal to a. Try to express each and every variable in terms of the same variable. Once you express that, use the constraint or condition, based on that you try to find out the critical points. Once we get the critical points, substitute these critical points in the given function, then we get the corresponding maximum or minimum. This is where to find out. Okay. Now I move to the next and last problem for Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Okay. Now I'm going to take the problem is the temperature. Yeah. Just a minute. Today's second problem, the temperature T at any point x, y, z in space is is T equals 400 x by z square. Find the highest temperature on the surface of the unit sphere x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 1. Yeah, the temperature T at any point x, y, z in space is the given what's a function, T is equal to 400 x, y, z square. Find the highest temperature on the surface of the unit sphere. The given on the, what's the condition on the unit sphere is x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 1. Then first try to write the auxiliary equation. What's my auxiliary equation? Capital, because it's involving three variables, f of x, y, z must be equal to function. What's the function they're given? 400 x, y, z square plus lambda into 5. First, you shifted one in the left hand side. That is nothing but x square plus y square plus z square minus 1. This is my auxiliary equation. And next, you find out what is my fx, fy, and fz. What is my fx? With respect to x, y and z are constant, y, z square is constant, derivative of x with respect to x is 1, a plus lambda into 2x. Y and z is constant, 1 also constant, 0. Similarly, I have to find out fy. What is my fy? 400 into x, z square is constant, derivative of x with respect to x 1, then we get 400 x, z square of 2y. With respect to y, x and z and constant is 0. And if with respect to z, 400 xy into derivative of z square with respect to z is 2z into 1 plus lambda into with respect to z, this is 0, 0 and 1 also 0, we get 2z. And then equal to fx is equal to 0, fy is equal to 0 and fz is equal to 0. Okay. We solved already in the previous class each and every step. Now what I'm going to do here, equal to 0. Once equal to 0, what we get lambda in the first expression? I'm going to write it directly because otherwise you write first equal to 0. 400 y z square plus lambda or 2 lambda x is equal to 0. 400 x z square 2 lambda y equal to 0. 800 x, y, z plus 2 lambda z equal to 0. And then these are implies what's my lambda? Lambda is equal to minus 400 y, z square by 2x. Right? And then what is my lambda here? Minus 400 x, z square divided by 2y. From the last one, lambda equals minus 800xyz divided by 2z. Okay. 2z. Then I have to simplify for this. Yeah. Lambda. This is, we have, if we want to, suppose you cancel this 2 ones or 2. To the what we get minus 200 y z square by x. Okay, this must be equal to, it's also must be equal to lambda. What's my lambda? Another value is this, what we get actually minus 200 x z square divided by y. That also must be equal to 400. 2 ones are 2 twos are 400 z z cancel x. And try to find out the relation between x, y, z. Equate A is equal to B and B is equal to C like that. Before, this implies minus 200 y, z square divided by x must be equal to minus 200 x, z square by y. Okay. Minus 200, minus 200 cancel. That implies z square also cancel. Okay. this and these are cancelled. That implies x square is equal to y square. That implies what is my x? X is equal to plus r minus y. Okay, fine. Similarly, I have to calculate. You take the last two. Minus 200 xz squared divided by y equals minus 400 xy. Okay. That implies, observe carefully here, minus 200, this is cancelled. What's the remaining 2? And then x and x are cancelled. Okay, fine. What do we get? Y square, z square is equal to y square. That implies z is equal to what? Plus r minus y. No, see, we did mistake here. 2 is remaining, right? 2, sorry. Z square is equal to 2. Y into y is y square. What is the value of this is? Actually, if z is equal to plus r minus root 2 into y. Or y into root 2. Okay, fine. Plus r minus root 2 into y. Please try to understand. This implies what's the remaining? Z square y is equal to 2y. Then we get z square is equal to 2y. That implies what is that? Plus r minus 2y. Then we get some set of values. Try to understand that. Then we have to move to the next step. Now, see here, I'm going to take if y is equal to, observe carefully, now we get that two values. What is that actually? 2y. That implies where I'm going to substitute these values. We are going to substitute this relation where in the given constraint or given condition. Okay. What's the given condition? Given x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 1. Okay. Now I'm going to take what actually? Either you take plus or minus or anything. What is square of that? We get plus. Suppose you take x is equal to minus y. That is equal to minus root 2y. Square of that, what we get actually? That implies z square is nothing but y square. This implies z square is equal to what? 2y square. Does not matter. Therefore, at x is equal to y and also y is equal to what actually? Root 2 into y. Either you take a plus or minus value or any this, we get same thing. x square is y square. Plus 2y square equal to 1. Okay. That implies 4y square is equal to 1. That implies what is y? Plus or minus 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Then I have to take 1 by 1. We have two values for y. At y is equal to half. At y is equal to half, we get two values for x. X is equal to half and also z is equal to, first I have to take x is equal to y and z is equal to y. What we get? X is equal to half and y is equal to, z is equal to what actually? Root 2 into 1 by 2 means 1 by root 2. Next you take, there are two possibilities. X is equal to y and x is equal to minus y and also z is equal to root 2 into y and also I have to take z is equal to minus root 2 into y. Then I have to take x is equal to minus y is minus half and z is also minus root 2 into y is 1 by 2. What we get? Minus 1 by root. Then we get two types of roots. Means nothing but half 1 by root 2. The another root is minus half. Yes, half and also minus 1 by root 2. Similarly, I have to take y is equal to minus half. At y is equal to minus half, what is my x value? X is minus half. Yeah, for x is equal to y and y is equal to root 2 into half. This is for z value. What is that? 1 by root 2. We are taken minus. This also we get minus sign. Next, you take x is equal to minus y. Please try to understand there are two possibilities. Either I have to take the two form, whatever that x is equal to y, z is equal to root 2 into y, x is equal to minus y and z is equal to minus root 2 into y. Now here x is y is equal to minus half, x is equal to minus y, we get 1 by 2. Z also we get plus because minus we are taking root 2 into minus root 2 into minus half. What we get? 1 by root. So finally we get, what are the roots? Minus half, half, minus 1 by root. And also half, half, yes, minus half. This is minus only. Which one? Y value. Y value I have taken what's in the second case? Minus. Minus half, okay. This is 1 by root. Okay. Totally we get 4 critical points, okay. Therefore, half, half, 1 by root 2, minus half, half, minus 1 by root 2, minus half, minus half, minus 1 by root 2, and half, minus half, 1 by root 2, are the critical points, or stationary points. Take any one of the name. At each point, I have to find out the given function. At, I take one by one. What is first function? First point, at half, half, 1 by root 2 for the function. What's the function? F of x, y. What is my f of x, y, z is nothing but the given temperature formula. What is that? 400 x, y, z square is nothing but what we get actually 400. What is my x? One. Observe carefully here. X is 1 by 2. This is also 1 by 2. Root 2 whole, 1 by root 2 whole square, 1 by 2. We get 8. Yes, we get 50. That implies what is my f? F of x, y, z at this point here? 50. Please try to understand. Just substitute the values here. Simple, that's why I'm not writing on the board. Simplification. Second point is minus half, half, minus 1 by root 2. For this, f of x, y, z, we get same 50, but here having minus, which one? X is minus and z is minus. Z whole square, minus z whole square is actually, once you substitute this value, if you want to substitute 400 into minus half, 1 by 2, into minus 1 by root 2 whole square. What we get? Minus 50. Actually, here we get minus 50. Because we are taking this value. X is minus half, correct? And then half, yes? This is half only, and then minus 1 by root 2. What is that? Minus 50. Minus 50. Once you put minus 50, the next is I want to find out at which value. What's the value? Minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by root 2. That implies f of x, y, z must be equal to 400 into what is my x value? X value is nothing but minus half. What is y value? Minus 1 by 2. What is z value? Minus 1 by root 2 whole square. Minus into minus plus. This is whole square plus. What we get actually? 50. And next, try to find out at which value? This one. The last value. Half, minus half, and then 1 by root 2. That implies f of x by z is nothing but 400 into what is x is 1 by 2, what is y is minus 1 by 2, what is my z is my 1 by root. root 2 whole square. You simplify that, we get minus 50. They are asking then, what's the maximum height they are asking. Therefore, compared to minus 50, plus 50 is the maximum height. Therefore, 50 is the highest temperature, not height actually, sorry. They are asking find the highest temperature. I want to know highest temperature. Minus 50, compared to minus 50 to plus 50, which one is highest temperature? Plus 50. Highest temperature on the surface of the unit sphere. Yeah, this is a way I to find out the highest or lowest. If you want to find out the minimum, lowest temperature is minus 50. This is a way I to find out maximum value or minimum value, or what's the maximum value, how we get, what are the dimension if you want to find out. There also I to find out by using Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. I think it's clear. Totally, I solved, including the last class, I solved three problems, different type of problems. You refer some more problem for any Grewal textbook for engineering mathematics, higher engineering mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal for 43rd edition. You refer it. And also they mention in the, please go to the website for video. You look into the blow up syllabus for first year 18 math 1-1. They mention which section I'm going to refer also. Based on that, you solve more number of problems. And also I'm going to upload my course material notes in video e-sikshana. If you want to refer more number of problems, I sort. But in the class, it's not possible to discuss all the problem. We are trying to convince the students, the concept. Therefore, based on the concept, we are discussing some few problems. Okay, fine. This is, I'm showing the entire problem in two screenshot, because it's not possible to show it the entire problem in one screenshot. Okay. This is a way I to solve the problem to find out the maximum or minimum value using whatever Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Before I'm going to wind up my session, I'm going to thank VTU, eSikshana, because they're giving the opportunity to deliver a talk through video. That is, I'm grateful. Thanks to VTU for all eSikshana committee members, and also VC, and also register, everyone, those who are both the registers, everyone, those who are involved directly and indirectly, to give an opportunity for to take deliver for video classes for first year and also third semester. Thank you very much. And also on behalf of my institution, from the Bangalore Institute of Technology, through our principal sir, I'm going to thank once again for VTU, VSikshana, to give a opportunity to deliver my talk. I don't know how much you clear. If you want to contact me, I'm going to write my email ID. Please put a message in a mail ID. Definitely I'm going to reply for that, for any queries. Okay, my email ID is Rupa. Rupa KM at bit.bangalore.edu.in. You please, if you have any queries, please mail this Rupa KM at BIT, Rupa KM at BIT, Bangalore.edu.in. Is it now? I think if you have any queries, please free to ask the queries through the mail. Once again, thank you very much on behalf of my institution to VTU to give an opportunity to deliver a talk. Okay. Bye. See you and take care. Again, I'll come back in the second semester, one of the module. Okay. Until you take care.